was really bad at math.
Especially in August.
But the problem is, it's May 24th, it's not really hard to suggest all the time.
What's it called, though?
It's the solstice thing, one of the solstices.
What's called the harvest? That's October. So what's the midwine? So actually, we would be preparing to harvest in October. So technically, when we did MAN again, during July, August, which is going to be October, November, we don't have to have it in the same way as everyone else. So basically, we'd be preparing people to harvest by October.
About the spring plant, the summer plant, the sort of harvest, and we can start announcing.
What is spring?
Spring planting?
Yeah.
Then without any engineering, we plant against Monsanto.
Okay, that means gold is that, that's a potato. Yeah.
Plant against Monsanto.
How do you think you guys was both of those concepts, or you want to do also you have targeting?
But we'll have to make some.
Well, I think for more rational, the most rational thing we could do is, are we doing it right?
Yeah, definitely on there. Nice to meet you.
Oh, is that Rosemary?
Hi, Rosemary.
This is Rosemary?
Is she there?
Hello?
Okay. There is this is I already got something planned. I already got like 1 month into this. It's called the Three Sisters. And the Three Sisters are corn, beans, and squash. And so you plant the corn, and the corn takes some nutrients, and the beans put other nutrients back. And then what happens? The corn you plant it like 2 weeks ahead of time, and then it starts to grow. And the beans is like a hole for the beans. So the beans go around the corn, and the beans put the nutrients back on one or the other. One sucks it up and one puts it back. And you put squash around it, and the squash keeps the moisture in the soil, and it grows that way. So you do that later, after a week or so later. And then also keep the moisture, and because it's sucking up the sun, the weeds do not grow around the corn and the beans. So you use them in a certain way, gay way, and there's some instructions. So once they grown up, this is how the American Indians used to grow their stuff.
I think it was on the top.
So
the Three Sisters.
Yeah. So here's some images of the Three Sisters. See, there is the Three Sisters.
Where is he?
Yes, right.
She basically gets her a call to get people to donate their lawns, and like we literally send out gardening teams to tear their stuff up and plant food. How many people?
We don't have to come on too.
Well,
I can get at least one. But even if people donate, yeah, if we can at least get people to donate them, then we can do stuff like this and like encourage people to begin tearing up their lawns and be like, and but it's a big project. A lot of people look at it and be like, I'm gonna tear up my lawn, I'm gonna plant a bunch of food. I have to figure out what gets sprinkled, what doesn't get sprinkled. But when you're like, look, we're going to send over 2 or 5 people or 8 people. We're going to tear up your lawn.
My question is that I think we're like, we're in a vacuum room. We're not realizing there's an organization that's like that. In LA, it's really good. I've never been suspicious.
Are you talking about Ron? It's perfect.
Yeah, this is a group that they farm their lawn. They give it to you and they give us money. It's like a food not bond group. It's a little different. But they also do the same food. So if you have stuff in your yard, they come pick your food.
Thank you, sir.
We're just hanging into the lawn.
We're talking about falling fruit.
Well,
we
think
that raise awareness about falling fruit on that day. Because there are people who are looking for food that don't know about falling fruit and that they can find food on falling fruit. Or they can even add their food to falling fruit. Like, I don't get my oranges.
And it's really... They'll work your lawn for
you. Yeah, see, that's in these are.
So Laura had a meeting up this way at one of these places up here. And she brought the corn food, she invited the guy that plays the foraging, the one guy who's foraging his rancher somewhere, and two other people that are heavily involved in similar things to what we're doing. And then, oh, and then James was there for the civil, ask people to bring it. Bring your compost.
Bring your compost, bring your dirt, but
you
like,
a whole bunch of farmers
we need a location. The location looks by a supermarket. If you want to do like do supermarket actions or whatever, do direct action. The question would be what community you need. But do people want to do that? Do you want to do a spring planting? Like this is the time.
Yeah, this is the time.
So I guess everyone can be able to continue to talk, or should we take like a sort of consensus at the end? And see what comes out.
Yeah, I just sort of feel like we're stepping on the toes of people that are doing this.
What do you mean?
Like, you know, when we planted that, we have a master garden up at Murr. At Murr, we have Emu down at the Venezuela garden. We got Don Silver. Like, these people have been doing this. These people have been rocking.
But that's what I'm saying. I think
and
it's just making a day for the city where we make all those things and resources available and, like, very visible. So it's not like saying, hey, we're taking over your shit. It's saying, hey, we're going to gather a bunch of these resources for the people. Set up here, or like we'll make you visible and like include you and put you on the flyers, or you'll have a booth or whatever you want.
So we're inviting you to participate.
To come participate. These are all via booths.
Yeah.
And we'll get them all. Whatever they can come up with. Them.
Or if they're like, hey, we'll have a thing in our location on that day, we'll be like, we'll make you one of the hosts. Like, we need more, you know what I mean? Like,
or
Venice
if you really are gung ho, maybe we'll make it a house.
Yeah.
Venice might have 40 people that want to work on this weekend. We'll do our house. Right?
Maybe. We already have, like, there's a lot of people go to market. We'll see. I mean, if we, to me, like, if we do, like, so you could do something where you have a hashtag where it's like, you don't have to wait to say, like, you should be marketing this content every day. So, like, submit your efforts, submit pictures of like what you've done, like whether you're seed bombing, whether you're blockading, like whatever building for the day, and then we have an event.
I think I like this place you described. Well, I haven't seen it.
Which one?
Where the Walmart's there.
Are you talking about the North Park?
Yeah, and there's a park there, so we can go to the park, and we'll be able to stop at some gathering.
You talking about Lamar Park?
Okay.
The Merck Park is it's all Central LA where Crenshaw and
there's a Walmart in the Merck Park and then there's a Walmart in downtown. But nobody's going to
Walmart.
Yeah.
Walmart
in downtown.
And then the Merck Park one has the issue of like black people going into the like area and
last year somebody was passing out these stickers.
They came from, they were given out at the Green Festival.
Oh, yeah.
And it was one of the booths at the Green Festival. I'm sure you can tell because I still have all that stuff in my folder. I mean, I think we should go through that brochure for the 2 years of the Green Festival and contact every one of those groups. I mean, there's no, you know, Andy has the 50 little tickets, the 500 little names we got, right? We have a lot of stuff.
Right.
There's a lot of hard contact there. We have support from the farmers market. All the stuff from our group came really from the farmers market in St. Louis. Right? Chef E, you know, I think he gave away our food the night before, but Randy was scrambled to get us more organic non-GMO stuff, mostly from the grand and food business. research on what words and stuff, but the graph is politically connected. So the graph has
They were supposed to give them all these requirements, but the city really only bought 10,000 of them. They were supposed to change the kids.
I think you heard part of the story, right? So, Obama campaign against healthy food on the plate in schools is centered around organic food growing in California. And they have gone public with all these media pieces about how it's really working here in California. But the truth is, the executive chef of the school district has not been directing the company that handles the school food purchasing to buy this organic food, because it is locally and organically. There's been jockeying back and forth about why won't you buy our stuff, and we're going to buy your stuff, we're buying your stuff, but you're not really buying your stuff. So the only purchase that happened was they paid $10,000, they bought $10,000 on the apple. And it was supposed to be out of a $130 million budget, it was supposed to be like $30 million earmarked specifically for organic food coming down this pipeline for the budget. And then there's another budget that's parallel to that that has to do with this is Obama issue, which is another $13 million, none of which is the use of purchase for organic food, because the company that controlled the purchasing and the distribution of food for the 550,000 students in the school district is like a little Walmart enterprise, and they don't want to pick up food from farms. They want it to come to them or pick it up in palletized, easily distributable, snack pack-like thing. So they don't really want to pick up 500 cases of apples. They want to pick up apple slices that are sliced and sealed with plastic bags. So there's this battle going on right now. And the fact that they're using this model around the country that doesn't really exist here. It's like smoke.
Can you get
I'm
Same with crystal meth. I mean, it takes all day to get it.
Are you talking about chefs from
I think
No,
chefs
not that chef.
Brazil?
He's a different chef.
There's a crazier chef?
Yes.
Oh, God. No.
Very eccentric.
It's not eccentric. It's just,
Who made those two, right?
He's a nice guy. I'm just saying that getting in a conversation about the nuances of what's going on here, it's almost like you need to circumvent him and go to the